Hello, and welcome to WingCast, a podcast about all things Goldwing. I'm your host, Rick Arnoldo, president of WingStuff.com and lifelong rider of the Honda Goldwing. In this podcast, we talk about the latest Goldwing news, speak with fellow riders and experts in the motorcycle industry, and discuss whatever else comes to mind. We'd love to have you join us. Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to episode 3 of WingCast. I'm your host, Rick Arnoldo, and I have a very special guy with me today. Hello, Fred Harmon. How are you this morning?
Good, Rick. How are you doing today?
Really good. A lot of our listeners out there probably know who you are. Fred and I have known each other for many, many years, and we've worked together on a lot of stuff. And we currently do videos together, some helpful accessory videos. And Fred has been phenomenal in cutting time down on installations on items like, for instance, the HomeLink system that opened your garage door for the new 2018 Plus Goldwing. You were able to cut the labor on that installation by almost 6 hours, I think. So we're putting out some good stuff like that. And then you're really well known for your video video series for maintenance. I mean, you have your 20 DVD set. It's like the service manual visually that it's just amazing how you put that together. Fred, to me, and he's probably going to be shy about this, but Fred is the most knowledgeable people in the world that I know of for the Honda Goldwing, both the old and the new. So, Fred, how did you get into motorcycles in the beginning? Maybe we should start there. Like, how did you even get into riding?
Well, you know, it's interesting, Rick. When I was a kid, my parents forbid us from having mini bikes or motorcycles.
Sounds like my mom.
Yeah, they were just sure we were going to kill ourselves, right?
Yeah.
So, but of course, we had some neighbor friends who had mini bikes. We always went over and rode theirs. So I think the first big, semi-big motorcycle, I'll say, I rode was a Honda Trail 90 when I was, you know, a teenager.
Yeah.
And then, of course, as soon as I got out of the house and went to college, the first thing I did was went out and bought the biggest motorcycle I could afford, which at the time was a Kawasaki KZ750, old 1980 model bike, only because I couldn't afford the Z1.
Right.
That's the bike I really wanted. But I stuck with Kawasaki's for quite a few years. I had several concourse motorcycles, probably four, I guess. And I got my first Goldwing in 2001 when they came out with the new GL1800 version.
Yeah.
That bike really kind of attracted me, and I liked the flat six. And so we got a 2001, and wife and I immediately jumped on it and started taking it on road trips out to Colorado and California. Up the West Coast. So I've kind of stuck with Goldwings ever since. I've had an FJR, and I still have a Kawasaki Concourse that I ride. So yeah, I had some other sport touring bikes, but I mainly ride the Goldwing now. So
yeah, you've been passionate about the Goldwing for a long time, and that's how you and I met many, many years ago. For those of you out there that don't realize, you know, Fred's done some amazing stuff. He did the 20 DVD set video series, complete maintenance on your Goldwing from 2001 to 2017, the GL1800. You have that entire service manual covered with just about anything you could possibly do, but up close and personal on video, which I thought was amazing. You helped so many people by doing that, because a lot of people don't like to read things. Although you and myself always suggest get a service manual. You should always have a factory service manual anyway, but you allowed it to become just so step-by-step and easy for people by doing that. And then when the 2018 Gold Wing came out, you did the same thing, except now we have on-demand. And if anybody's interested, you know, those are on wingstuff.com as well for the older 1800s and the new 2018 Plus. And you're up to, I believe, 55 or 54 videos now on your on-demand for the new Gold Wing?
Yeah, that's right. I have 55, I believe.
55?
You know, it's interesting how that all evolved.
Yeah, how did that happen? Because I'm sure people want to know about that.
You know, I've been on the Gold Wing forum for years, and I kind of grew into sort of a technical advisor type role. I worked for the Concourse Owners Group as their tech editor for years. And so I was always on the forum answering technical questions about how to do stuff, how to fix stuff on the Gold Wing.
Yeah.
And I got tired of answering the same questions over and over again. And it occurred to me one day, you know, I could make a video on how to do some of this stuff, because we'd done some of that in the concourse world on how to adjust your valves. And I thought, you know, maybe I'll just make a video and I'll just make a few DVD copies and I'll just mail them out to some of these guys. So I started shooting the video, and I guess it took me about, you know, one thing led to another. I was just going to film a few basic things, and it grew. I almost kind of couldn't stop. And by the time I got done, I literally stripped the whole bike apart and shot it on video. And so I went to make the discs, and these are 2-hour DVDs, and I ended up, the first set was 28 hours long, took 14 DVDs.
Wow.
So I started looking at, well, how am I going to send out copies of 14 discs? You know, I asked online, well, how many people are interested in this? And I got like hundreds of people said, yeah, I want a copy.
Sure.
And I thought, well, how am I, you know, this is going to cost me money to make, right? I mean, you know, these things aren't free. So I started looking in the cost, and I found a publishing company that could press them.
Yeah.
And so one thing led to another, and, you know, next thing I know, I had it for sale. I was originally just going to give them away for free.
Right.
Until I realized how much it was going to cost me to make them.
Oh, so, sure. And the fact that you can actually make them is incredible, because there's not many people, feel good about yourself, there's not many people that have the ability and the technical ability to put videos like that together. You basically were teaching people on video how to do everything in that shop manual, which, yeah, you know, you've helped so many people all over the world.
Yeah. Well, you mentioned in the beginning, you know, how I cut down the installation time on the HomeLink install on the 2018. And one of the tricks is, you know, there are some things that Honda tells you to do that you don't have to do, but there's other things that you absolutely have to follow the manual on.
Right.
And the trick is knowing where you can have, what shortcuts are actually safe to use,
right,
you know, and where you can get away with doing shortcuts and where you absolutely have to follow the manual.
Right.
So,
and you're the guy that tells us how to do that. That's
right.
That's the joy of having somebody like you to be able to help people out there that
right,
kind of help, you know?
Well, I have a pretty strong both mechanical and electrical background. I went to college and got a degree in basically in electrical engineering applied to aircraft, and worked in the aircraft industry for years. And I actually did training for maintenance troops on how to do maintenance procedures on the F-16 and on other airplanes. So, you know, I kind of have had a lot of experience in taking things apart and putting them back together, and
Sure.
And where you have to follow the guidelines and where you can find shortcuts at and,
sure.
and that kind of stuff. So it just kind of naturally led me into, you know, motorcycling was always my hobby, and it naturally led me into working on motorcycles because I actually found that I almost enjoy working on bikes as much as I do riding them. So
yeah, that's so great.
I enjoy taking them apart and figuring out what makes them tick and how to make them better.
You're the real deal, Fred. You're the real deal. I've been lucky to have you as a friend for so many years. So you've always been my go-to guy. Like when I don't have an answer for something, I call you. It's like, you know, it's like, well, I'm not sure about that. Let me find out and I'll call Fred. And so, you know, I think through your videos and what you've done for people and this new Gold Wing, the 2018 Plus, having these on-demand do-it-yourself maintenance videos, huge, huge for people. And we're excited about, you know, doing a lot of the videos that we've been doing together with you, you know, yourself and WingStuff together to help people like the HomeLink, where instead of spending all day installing something, you show them how to do it and you cut 6 hours off the installation. Or another good example is the Muth mirrors, which we love Muth mirrors. I mean, one of the most popular products that we sell, and you were able to cut that installation time down by a lot. I think it was like by how many hours? Like a couple of hours.
Yeah, at least, because they want you to remove all the side panels and the top shelter.
Yeah.
Just to fish the wire down through,
yeah.
you know, down back to the seat. And you know, the trick is you can actually do that with a coat hanger. You can work the coat hanger down underneath the bodywork and just fish the wire through, and you don't have to take any of that stuff off.
See, this is the kind of stuff that people love because it really helps them. And right. some people are afraid to try to install things because they don't know how, but they don't realize that if you just follow the steps one by one, a lot of these accessories aren't that complicated. They're very easy, but yeah. people are afraid. They're afraid right. to touch their bike. Right. What you're doing is you're making...
And that's where the videos really help. And I found was the main thing the videos provide you is you kind of have a sense of going into a project, you know what you're going to face because you've already seen it. So it gets you over that fear of taking the bike apart for the first time. You know, you've yeah. never done it before. You don't know what's under the top shelter. You don't know what challenges you're going to face. And,
yeah.
And these bikes actually, I think, aren't as hard to work on as people think they are.
Sure.
The main challenge is just getting over your fear of you know, can I really do this? And that's what the videos were intended to do. So
yeah. people get very intimidated. They're afraid. And then once they see the videos and they start actually doing things, maybe after the first time they installed something on their bike, they realize that wasn't so bad. That was actually,
yeah.
it was yeah. easy. And yeah. I'm not afraid anymore. And so, yeah, so, you know, thank you for doing all that stuff for people. I mean, I'm sure. speaking on behalf of everybody out there. We, you know, we're just all very lucky to have somebody like you. And that's why I like helping people like you do. So, and we won't get in, this is really about you, but that's, I started WingStuff. I didn't know I was going to do this for the rest of my life. Kind of same thing what you did with the videos. I started doing this to help people. And then before mm-hmm. I knew it, this is what I'm going to do for the rest of my life because I love what I do, you know.
Also been working with some of the other vendors that I'm sure you're familiar with. I've worked with Lewis at Electrical Connections
sure.
in helping him develop some new products.
Yeah.
I've worked with Traction Dynamics in developing some of their suspension components.
Yeah.
I'm working very closely with Don Gould at Gould Motors. We've found a way to actually reflash the ECMs on the new Goldwing, and so you know we can do some things with the changes in the ECM that go beyond what even Honda had envisioned the bike to do.
Wow, that's interesting.
You know, one of the big complaints has always been Honda reduced the speed limiter in 2018 down to 112 miles an hour.
Yeah, I have heard.
And it actually kicks in at around 100 miles an hour. It starts to reduce your power. So it gradually, you know, you gradually start to lose power. And, you know, normally guys won't want to ride that fast, but it's nice to know that if you ever needed to, you could. And so right. One of the things Don has done is been able to figure out a way to defeat the speed limiter. So make other nice changes. He's made some changes to both tour and sport mode, the throttle mapping. You know, a lot of people complain that sport mode's just a little bit too touchy on this bike, especially mm-hmm. in second and third gear at low RPMs, like if you're in a parking lot and you're in sport mode. And so he's trimmed the sport mode down a little bit so it's a little less twitchy. And then on the same hand, he's been able to improve the tour mode so the tour mode has a little more power. So you may not have to switch to sport mode as often. You can actually get a little more power out of tour mode.
Interesting.
He's also found a way to program the bike so it'll stay in the last mode you put it in. So if you put it in, and that's a nice feature. For example, if it's raining and you put it in the rain mode, and you pull into a gas station and turn off the bike to fill it up with gas, you turn it back on, you know, you may forget that the bike normally will default back to tour mode. Well, with this reflash, the bike will stay in rain mode. So when you start it back up, it'll stay where you put it in the last time. So that's been some interesting stuff we've been working on recently that kind of groundbreaking.
Neat. You know, that leads me into asking you, you were mentioning to me that there were some changes on the 2020 model that actually weren't even talked about. Not a lot, but there were a few changes that people don't even know. You might want to highlight on that for people out there that are wondering. You said there were some updates that you wanted to share with mm-hmm. people. What were those?
Yeah, there was some misinformation put out by some of the motorcycle press articles that I read mm-hmm. on the 2020 that indicated they had changed the dampers in the transmission on the fork dampers. And they also had referred to the Gen 3 DCT version. And the articles made it sound like the 2020 had a whole new DCT transmission with changes in it. And that's actually not true. The Gen 3 DCT was the one that was released in 2018.
Okay.
And it did have those dampers in the forks. What Honda changed is they changed the firmware in what's called the transmission control module mm-hmm. to change the RPMs, the RPMs at which the bike automatically downshifts on deceleration. So they lowered those RPMs. And so as a result, you know, if you've ridden the 2018-2019 bike and you notice sometimes maybe when you're coming up to a stoplight and you roll off the throttle, you'll kind of feel the bike downshifting and you'll feel the deceleration as the bike goes down through the gears.
Yeah.
What they did in 2020 is they dropped that RPM at which the downshift occurs so you don't get so much engine braking. And you don't, the downshifts are a little softer and feel a little more natural in the 2012, but it was strictly a software change. There was not any internal changes to the transmission itself. They also made some changes in the ECM to the throttle mapping, similar to what Don Gould is working on now. They reduced the twitchiness of the sport mode a little bit.
Sure.
And I think they smoothed out the tour mode as well. So Honda recognized that the sport mode was a little twitchy in the lower gears and tried to make some changes in 2020 to fix that. And in speaking with, I have contacts in Japan at Honda, and speaking with them, they informed me that you could actually purchase the engine control module, the ECM, and the transmission control module from the 2020, and you could retrofit those into a 2018 bike, and you would have the same, basically the same riding bike as a 2020. Now, obviously, it'd be an expensive proposition. It's about $1,800 for those two modules.
$2,000, yeah.
But if somebody wanted to, you know, and didn't want to buy a new bike just to get that that smoother transmission, they could actually do that. So that was interesting. They also changed the shocks, and the changes to the shocks was not really, it's pretty minor. It was not as big a change as I would have liked to see. They did not change the spring rates at all. So the shocks still have the same springs on them.
Right.
They changed the internal damping very slightly in both front and rear shocks. And they changed the size and the shape of the what's called the rubber bumper down on the bottom of the front shock. They made the rubber bumper a different shape and size.
Mm-hmm.
And that was really a pretty subtle change. You can sort of feel the difference on the 2020 when you ride it. You'll notice maybe the little arms on the steering rods that bounce up and down when you go down the road. They don't bounce quite as much on the 2020. So you can detect a very slight change in the damping, but it's still, in my opinion, undersprung and underdamped.
A little soft in the front. Yeah, my DC.
Yeah, it is. And that's where the traction shocks can really help out a bike. Yeah. So,
yeah. My 2018, I absolutely love the way it handled, right? But I always felt like, for whatever reason, the Gold Wings have always been a little soft, especially in the front. And
right.
This new bike is no different, although I love the handling of it. But I upgraded to the traction shocks as well, and it got rid of that soft, you know, front end.
Yeah.
And
it's a big improvement.
Yeah.
I'm actually a traction dealer, and I install those shocks, so
yeah,
I've done a lot of bikes, and every customer I get that brings me a bike that I work on and put those shocks on, they call me the next day and they say, man, this is a whole different motorcycle.
Well, that's why aftermarket suspension's available in the first place, because
right.
It proves what's on the bike stock. And when that bike came out, people were like, well, what's wrong with the suspension? Nothing. The suspension's fine. As a matter of fact, out of the box, stock, I thought the 2018 was the best handling Gold Wing I've ever ridden in my life, even comparing it to bikes that had traction kits or race tech or progressive suspension, didn't matter. That bike in stock form was the best handling Gold Wing I've ever ridden. But now when you get that bike, you know, can you make that even better? You know, they didn't think
right.
They could improve the previous model. So, you
right.
know, you keep improving. So people don't know any better, but so, you know, you put aftermarket suspension on any bike, any brand bike you can think of course it's going to be better than stock.
Yeah. Yeah. I thought this, you know, the first time I rode the new Gold Wing, I got invited to the press launch down at Austin by Honda.
Texas. Yeah.
And down and, you know, I rode the bike for about 2 days and I came back and I said, man, that suspension is so smooth and, you know, and I really liked it. And then after I bought one and rode it for a while, and I did realize the front end was starting to bottom out a little. It's a whole lot better than the old bike.
Sure.
But it can still be improved on, right? And that's what traction does, is they make what's good even better. So
exactly. And I like the way you said that, because there are so many people that had the wrong impression. I said, well, what's the difference between the older 1800 Gold Wing and even before that, the 1500 Gold Wing? I said, we were selling, you know, heavy duty fork springs and air shocks for that bike. And I said, this is no different. So,
right.
But they hit it out of the park with this bike because the suspension's just phenomenal. You know, and making that phenomenal suspension even better. Well, you know, that takes it to a whole level. You know, by the way, I want to mention through this podcast, if any of you out there have questions for Fred, in upcoming podcasts, we're going to be having a little segment in them called Tech Talk with Fred. And Tech Talk with Fred will be, you can email in your questions, and we'll pick the questions that we feel people will get the most help in Fred answering. And you can send them in to wingcast@wingstuff.com, and you'll have a chance of maybe getting Fred to answer your technical question. It could be a technical question, hopefully, because that's Fred's his strong suit. But it also could be a little, you know, maybe his advice on something. So anyway, we encourage the people out there to send in your questions to wingcast@wingstuff.com, and it would be for Tech Talk with Fred. And so I appreciate Fred going ahead and doing that for people going forward, because I think there's a lot of people out there that would like some things answered, and there's nobody out there to answer it. And there's nobody, I feel, better than you to answer it, Fred. So thank you for doing that. And then, you know, one other thing, one of our listeners emailed us, and by the way, everybody, please, you know, engage with us. Feel free. Don't be shy. Send us emails on what content you'd like to see, what you'd like to hear us talk about. If you have questions for Fred Harmon. And also, one of our listeners, Dan G, we're not going to give his last name. Dan emailed us letting us know that Honda just released an announcement that they're going to have support for the Android phone coming in June 2020, Fred, which that's exciting because not everybody has an iPhone, you know?
I've been in contact with Honda about that, and they believe it's going to be out in June. Originally, it's going to be out in May. But, you know, they've been working on getting Android Auto into their firmware for quite a while. The reason Honda did not initially have Android Auto available was not because Honda didn't want to do it. It was because Google, they approached the company that builds Android Auto, and they said, no, we're not interested in doing that for a motorcycle.
Really?
So that's why you only had CarPlay for iPhones available on the bike, was because manufacturer basically told Honda, no, we're not going to do that.
Interesting.
And I think later changed their mind, and so they've been working on it for a couple of years now.
And you know, a fun fact about that subject, Honda was the first company to actually put Apple CarPlay integration on a motorcycle with that 2018.
That's right.
Yeah.
And you know, this last firmware update, I don't know if you noticed, but previously, in order to use CarPlay, you had to connect your headset first to the motorcycle and plug in your iPhone. Well, they released a firmware update in January, and you don't have to do that anymore. You know, it used to be if you pulled into the gas station and turned off the bike and turned it back on, you had to unplug and replug your iPhone back in to get CarPlay to come back up.
Oh, it was a pain in the butt.
They fixed that now in the January update. And this update coming out in June is supposedly going to make some corrections to the GPS system as well. One of the big complaints has been the road colors kind of blend into the background color. They're almost the same color. A lot of the small roads are yellow on a white background, and it's a little hard to see.
Yeah.
So I believe they're going to make it where the user can actually go in and select their own map background colors, so you can get a little better contrast on the roads. So there's going to be some other big changes, I think, in this June update that everybody's looking forward to.
Good.
And, you know, in my conversation with the designers in Japan, they informed me that they plan on making changes to this motorcycle every single year. They say every model year, we're planning changes every model year on this motorcycle, making improvements on
That's it. Great. They're very committed to this bike. This is their flagship bike.
Yeah, they sure are.
Sometimes they have a reputation of being more of a conservative company, but, you know, they are behind this new Gold Wing 1,000%. And by you saying that, that just confirms that, you know.
Yeah.
They're committed to the motorcycle, and they're committed to making the motorcycle evolve and continue to improve and get better and better than it is now.
Right.
And I love hearing that, you know.
Yeah, and that's good news for the future of the, you know, the current Gold Wing. You know, that speaks to, you know, the bike's going to continue to evolve and improve every year, and it's going to give it, you know, it's going to give it a good long life. And it's just like, you know, I saw in the aircraft world, you know, when the first model F-16s came out, we had all kinds of problems with them. And as that airframe matured over the years, you know, by the time I retired, it wasn't anything like the first models that had come out. You know, they literally improved every aspect of the airplane. And that's what happens when you let vehicles mature and you continue to work on them and improve them.
Yeah.
You know, every model year gets a little better than the previous model years.
And I'm excited to hear that, because, you know, I've always loved motorcycles in general my whole life since I was a kid, but, you know, and I've worked with Honda for so many years, but, you know, this is my passion too. You know, I started WingStuff 21 years ago because I had such a passion for this particular motorcycle.
Right.
So, you know, knowing that, you know, they're behind it, you know, so much and with this much commitment, and they're going to continue to make this bike better and better every year, that makes me very happy. And I think smart, because this is not only the flagship bike for that company, but, you know, in the world, you know, Harley is the company that comes to mind when you think about lifestyle. And other than Harley, and I'll say BMW too, they have a good following, the Honda Goldwing, you know, Honda is the only company that I can think of, out of just Japan especially, that nobody has come close to creating that Harley lifestyle. Mm-hmm. Any other motorcycle besides a Harley, but Honda has come pretty close.
Yeah.
They've done it.
Yeah, you know, you look around at the other manufacturers who still make what I would call a luxury touring motorcycle, which is a category that Goldwing falls in.
Yeah.
And nothing really close. There's nothing out there that compares to that bike. There's really not. And I think all the other manufacturers just came to the conclusion that they could not compete with Honda or in that marketplace because the Goldwing has just basically run away with it.
They've done such a great job on this bike for so long, evolving it and making it better and better, that you're right. I don't think anybody's even close. And there's some nice bikes out there. Don't get me wrong.
Right.
I went to New Zealand. I was riding a BMW, and I really enjoyed it. But it wasn't my Goldwing, and especially DCT. I love my bike. I really do. And I do this for a living, but I can tell you that I really love my DCT. It's the best Goldwing ever, you know.
And, you know, if you like to tour two up with your wife on the back of the motorcycle, there's just no other bike out there that does passenger comfort like the Goldwing does. Yeah. You know, my wife and I get on the bike and we go on 4-week trips. I mean, we'll go on a 8,000-10,000 mile trip and go out and do the whole West Coast. And
there you go. North. Come visit me in San Clemente. Come to Southern California, Fred.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we used to go to California every year, and we'd ride up, ride all the way up the Oregon coast, all the way up to Seattle.
Sure.
And and then go across over the Cascades and come back down through Montana and Wyoming and Colorado and do a whole big Western U.S. loop. And
see that?
I can't think of any other motorcycle I could do that on with my wife.
Sure.
And still be married, when we got back home.
That's a good point because, the Goldwing, when I think about the people that ride Goldwings, right, it's something that you can do with your wife, with your girlfriend, and you'll end up doing it more because there's not a lot of recreation or things that you can enjoy together as a couple. Right. And so I've seen so many people, that's why they say lifestyle, because you get groups and clubs and or maybe just get the wife like you said and head west, let's go for a month or let's go for 6 weeks, and so I always love when you come to visit California. I'll go with you, we'll go for a nice ride, I'll take you on some of my rides,
Okay.
I know you've got a lot near you. I've been towards Arkansas. I know Fred used to live in Texas before, and he recently moved to Arkansas. And when I went on a ride with some industry people about 7 or 8 years ago, and we left Fort Worth, Texas, and we went for a week, and we went through like Mount Magazine and Oklahoma and into Arkansas. And I'll tell you what, I never realized how beautiful that part of the country was. I thought it was all flat,
Right.
And Arkansas, I know you have nice mountains, but Oklahoma, I didn't realize how nice it was. Out that we went to get to Arkansas through Oklahoma.
Right. There's some pretty areas out here.
Oh, yeah.
We enjoy it.
I liked it. But again, I just want to remind everybody out there, in upcoming episodes, we want to encourage you guys, if you have any questions for Fred or myself, feel free to email us at wingcast@wingstuff.com. I also want to encourage everyone, if you have an older 1800 Goldwing, check out the 20 DVD video series that we sell on WingStuff from Fred Harmon. All you have to do is go on WingStuff.com and type in Fred Harmon, and it will come up. And it's H-A-R-M-O-N, for those of you who aren't sure how to spell his last name. And so we have the video, I call it visual service manual, for the 2001 through 2017 GL 1800, and now the on demand is up to 55 videos for the 2018 plus Goldwing, and that's on Wing Stuff as well. And so, in upcoming segments, we're going to just call Fred up and get him to answer some of those questions that come in. So feel free. And I don't want to keep you any longer, Fred. I think we had a real nice kind of up close and personal get together today, and I wanted to get some of the people out there to kind of know you a little bit more.
Sure.
And that was the whole reason I wanted to get you on this episode of WingCast, and in the future we'll have Tech Talk with Fred, and people I know will really be excited to be able to ask questions to someone that can answer them. So we might not be able to answer all the questions, of course, because that would be impossible, but we do encourage people to send us your questions, and it could be technical for Fred, or it could be just questions about the Goldwing or recommendations or advice or whatever you guys want to talk about, and preferably around the subject of Honda Goldwings, because that's a true passion that we all have. Obviously, I have, Fred has, and we want to try to help all of you and try to make this a fun experience for you to look forward to our podcast. And there's a lot of other people that I want to interview going forward, manufacturers that make things for your bikes that want to share things with you. And I think there's a whole lot of great information that is helpful, and it's certainly to keep people entertained at the same time. So I'm not going to keep you any longer, Fred. I appreciate the time we had today. And until next time, I'm going to say goodbye, everybody. And thank you very much, Fred, for your time today.
Thank you, Rick.
All right. Bye, everybody. All right, everybody. Well, we had a great time with my friend Fred Harmon on that podcast episode. But now I think it's time to call the real star, and that's Uncle Frank. So let's check in on Uncle Frank and see what Uncle Frank is doing right now. So I'm just going to cold call Uncle Frank.
I was going to say, he never called me all day yesterday.
Oh, I didn't call you all day. I thought I talked to you. I thought I called you in the morning, and then you were having something.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, you were having something.
I'm falling asleep now. I'm falling asleep at the wrong time.
Well, that's
because I get up 4 o'clock this morning.
Yeah, because
sleep no more.
Yeah, because yeah, the problem is you sleep during the day on and off in your chair watching TV, and then you go to bed at night and you can't sleep solid sleep.
I couldn't sleep.
I know.
I'm trying to sleep and I fall asleep on a chair.
All right. Well, you know what we got to do?
4 o'clock this morning.
You know how we got to keep you from falling asleep in the chair is you got to put on a good movie that keeps you interested, like James Bond. Right? So.
My eyes again like that.
Oh.
I get tired.
Hey, Uncle Frank, by the way, I have you live again. This is another podcast that we just did. I just did an episode with a friend of mine, Fred Harmon, who is a very technical kind of person in the Gold Wing business. And so I just wanted to call you and just say hi to you. So you want to say hi to everybody out there?
Where is he?
No. I have you on a...
Somebody way over here. What are you talking about?
No, listen. I said you're live on the air. I have you on a podcast again. So I wanted you to say hello to my friends out there listening to the podcast. So give them one of your Uncle Frank, the hey, give them one of your A's.
Yeah, they living out there.
No, listen, I have you on, it's like a live radio station. You're live right now. You're live.
From where? From California?
Yes. I'm broadcasting from California and all, everybody. You're going to say hello to everybody that's listening, and they could be anywhere in the world that are listening to you right now. So give them one of these. Give them an Uncle Frank. Hey!
Right, that's the way you do it with them.
Yeah, that's what we call your segment. We call, hey, with Uncle Frank. That's what we call your segment on the podcast.
Yeah, all right. Who am I talking to? They're going to put me on.
No, you're on now. So give them one of those Uncle Frank. Hey!
Hey, radio.
All right, good, perfect. All right, that's all. You know, people like to hear that. They want to hear Uncle Frank give them.
I sit here all day and say, yay.
Well, you just need some good movies to look forward to watching.
Put it in the background. You got Georgie on the line, too.
No, I didn't bring Georgie on the line. But anyway, I'm going to let you. I don't have anybody else on the line except everybody in the world who's listening. So there's a lot of people listening.
Somebody made a laugh before that.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe that was me.
I did that.
Maybe it was me and you thought somebody was
there. How can somebody all over the world hear me?
Because you're on a podcast. But anyway, let's say goodbye to everybody, Uncle Frank, and thank them for listening. And if they have any requests or anything they want to hear us talk about or any technical questions for Fred Harmon, which is called Tech Talk with Fred, they just need to email us at wingcast@wingstuff.com. So again,
what time is it out there now? I don't know.
It's 10:30 in the morning, and it's 10:30 here in the morning, but it's 3 hours ahead there.
Yeah. All right.
Well,
hey, 10:30.
There you go. All right, Uncle Frank. I just wanted to call and say hi, and I wanted to.
Because I didn't know if you called me this morning or not.
No, this is the first time this morning I called you, but I did call you yesterday morning.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I'll let you go, and I'll call you later today, okay?
Yeah, okay.
All right.
Okay.
All right, Uncle Frank. Love you.
All You too.
Okay. Bye.
What time is it out there now?
10:32 in the morning.
10:30 in the morning.
Yep. Yep.
Oh, okay.
Okay, Uncle Frank. I love you.
All right.
All right. Love you. All right. See you later.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye.
Thanks for listening to WingCast. This has been a WingStuff.com production. Please be sure to rate, review, and subscribe to us wherever you listen to podcasts. Got a question or comment for me? Send an email to WingCast@WingStuff.com, and it could be featured on a future episode. You can also visit WingStuff.com and sign up for our newsletter to stay up to date on the newest podcast episodes, products, videos, Goldwing news, sales, and more. Until next time, I'm Rick Arnoldo. Ride safe.